what this bacteria will do, now it is containing rDNA and bacteria will start cloning. Cloning means it will multiply very fastly. What is going on inside the DNA, rDNA? This gene or this rDNA will undergo transcription and translation. Means they will form two things inside. Okay, what type of two things? Pre-proinsulin and palicinase. Pre-proinsulin means what and palicinase means what? I'll tell you. Pre-proinsulin means it is the insulin. It is the inactive form of insulin, but we want active form of insulin. No. So what the scientists have done, they had purified this pre-proinsulin by using trypsin treatment, and purified insulin is collected and it is stored. Now, what about this palicinase? Penicillinase is the enzyme which kills the antibiotic penicillin. Now, what is penicillin? Penicillin is nothing but antibiotic which kills the bacteria. Okay, we are taking antibiotic penicillin to kill the bacteria. Okay, but what this bacteria had done, this bacteria produces or secreted enzyme palicinase. Means now this bacteria is not at all get killed by the penicillin. Okay, it means in another way, it increases its resistance power against penicillin. So in this way, insulin is collected. Now, next one is vaccine production. Insulin, human insulin, we have covered. Now we have to see vaccine production. See students, every time the technique of rDNA is same. Okay, now we'll see what is vaccine. See, vaccine is nothing but it is the biological preparation that provides active acquired immunity in humans. This definition, what is vaccine, you have to keep in mind. What is vaccine? Vaccine is nothing but biological preparation. Okay, in the medical field, it is prepared vaccine. What is its function? It provides active acquired immunity in humans. Now I'll explain you what is the meaning of different types of immunity first. Okay, active immunity means what? See, when the body produces antibodies, automatically the body produces its own antibodies, that is called as active immunity. Passive immunity means when the antibodies are injected inside the body. This difference you should know. Active immunity means when the antibodies are automatically produced by the body, that is called as active immunity. Passive immunity means when the antibodies are injected in the body, that is called as passive immunity. Okay, now what are antibodies? Antibodies also you should know. Antibodies are nothing but they are the chemicals produced by the body when microorganisms enters the body. See, in our body also this is happening. Sometimes what happens, naturally the microorganisms are coming and entering our body unknowingly, means we don't know, but what our body is doing, the body is producing antibodies against that microorganisms. This process is going on inside only. We are not aware of these things, but whenever the microorganisms are entering our body, these antibodies are automatically produced by our body. Okay, and that antibodies are giving protection against those microorganisms. Now, these antibodies produced by the body against microorganisms, how they are attacking the microorganism, just see, when antibodies are produced against the microorganism, that antibody binds to the antigen. Suppose, I'll take one example. Suppose this is virus, or you can say this is the microorganism. These are the antigens. Okay, each and every microorganism contains the antigen. Suppose these are the antigens. Actually, what is the function of these antigens? These antigens produces toxic protein, which causes disease in our body. What we are studying? We are studying this is the virus. Okay, or you can say this is the microorganism. It contains antigen. These antigen produces toxic protein in our body, okay, and it is responsible for causing any type of disease. But what happens, what these antibodies are doing, these antibodies binds this antigen. Okay, these antibodies are just binding this antigen. Now this, because of this binding, the antigens are unable to produce the toxic substance. And though the microorganisms are entering in the body, in our body, they are not secreting harmful protein. Okay, and we are disease free. Okay, Now, what is innate immunity? Again, there are two types of immunity, innate immunity and acquired immunity. Innate means the immunity which is there right from birth. That is called as innate immunity. Acquired immunity means the immunity which develops as we grow. Okay, as the child grows. For example, chickenpox vaccine. Chickenpox antibodies are not there in our body. When we are taking the antibodies, when we are taking the vaccine, the antibodies get developed in our body against the chickenpox. Okay. So in short, I want to say vaccines are nothing but they are the weakened or killed form of virus. How vaccine are produced, that I am going to explain you now. Okay. But at present, you have to keep in mind, vaccine is a weakened or killed form of virus. Here the viruses are weakened, are made weak. Okay. So what we are studying? We are studying vaccine production. What is vaccine? Vaccine is nothing but biological preparation that provides active acquired immunity in human beings. I have explained you, active immunity means the immunity which is present right from when the antibodies are present, are produced automatically. That is called as active immunity. Passive immunity means when the antibodies are injected in the body. Okay, innate immunity means the immunity which is present right from the birth. Acquired immunity means the immunity develops as the child grows. Okay, antibodies, what are antibodies? Antibodies are nothing but the chemicals, okay, produced by the body only against the microorganisms. Okay, what the antibodies are exactly doing? When the microorganism is there, microorganism is containing antigens. These antigens are releasing toxic material, or you can say toxic protein. This toxic protein is causing disease in our body. But what our antibodies are doing? Antibodies are just binding this antigen of this harmful microorganism. They are binding the antigen, means now nobody is there to secrete the harmful toxin. So that microorganism is ineffective. It is unable to cause disease in human being. Okay, so here I have taught you about vaccine. Now let's see how vaccine is produced. It is same like RDNA technology. See, this is polio vaccine. How we can produce, artificially we can produce polio vaccine. Polio vaccine, in polio vaccine, no, first of all, the polio virus is there. You know, polio virus is there. This polio virus is made from weakened polio. Polio vaccine is made from weakened polio virus. Means exactly what we are doing. See, this is polio virus. Polio virus is there, which is having antigen. You know, virus is effective only because of, virus is toxic only because of the presence of this antigen. This is virus. Suppose this is polio virus, and polio virus is having antigen. This antigen is responsible for the production of toxic protein, which is responsible for the production of, or for the for causing this polio disease. Okay, so how polio vaccine is produced from this harmful virus, that I am going to explain you. See, what the scientists are doing, they are first polio vaccine, they are making this virus weakened. How they are making this virus weakened? They are just modifying this virus, means they are removing the harmful parts of antigen, which is responsible for production of harmful protein. What they are doing? They are just making this part useless. They are removing the part of antigen, which is responsible for causing harmful, or for secreting harmful or toxic protein. Okay. Then this virus is inserted in the body. Now this virus is harmless, okay, because the antigen, harmful parts of the antigens are removed, which are producing toxic proteins are removed. Now this polio virus becomes weakened because it is not secreting harmful toxin. Now this virus is introduced in the body. Okay, introduced in the body, that virus will remain alive, but it is unable to cause a disease because the harmful parts has been removed. Now what happens, whenever we are taking, when this virus is introduced in the body will recognize that, okay, foreign particle or foreign microorganism had entered in the body. this virus is entered in our body, but it was weakened. It is weakened virus because it is not producing any toxin protein. Okay, but the body will recognize that, okay, foreign virus has been entered or foreign microorganism is entered in the body. What the body will do? Body will start preparing the antibodies against that virus. But that virus is weakened. But our body will recognize that foreign virus has entered in the body, and it will start preparing the virus.